turn of a card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Pontiac Fiero. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you all very much. Thank you, Gene. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. I'm in a good mood today. We're going to start the week out. We got a new car back there, Pontiac GT. Somebody's going to walk out of here, hopefully, today with that. We gave a good car away last week. I don't want to waste any more time. Let's meet our lovely dealers. Here they come right now, ladies and gentlemen, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Woo! What is this? This is interesting. This is interesting. Yeah, we've got some guys downstairs. I always know it's an interesting outfit when the guys in the front of the audience have binoculars. That's the way I always look at it.
No,
it looks very interesting. What kind of material is this? What is it?
Chiffon.
Chiffon?
Yeah.
Okay, well, shuffle on over there, ladies, and deal out the cards. Let's meet our card sharks. Here they come. Hello, Jack.
Hi, Bill.
Here is Jack from Hot Springs, Arkansas.
And it's good to see you.
It's good to see you, sir. For the folks that are just tuning in, why don't you tell the folks at home a little something about yourself.
Alrighty, I'm in guest relations, and I audit for a very large hotel firm in Hot Springs, Arkansas.
Yeah, Jack is our champion. He's in the champion's position right now to the tune of $13,419 cash and prizes. That is not a bad, couple of days' work for you, Jack. And Jack wants more. Jack certainly does want more. This young lady, I can't wait for you to hear. I'm just going to let her introduce herself. Go ahead, introduce yourself, Cindy.
My name is Cindy Osbach. I am from Pennsylvania. I'm 6 months pregnant, and one of my all-time hobbies is exploring caves.
Exploring caves?
Yes, indeed.
What is that called?
There is a special word for it, but believe it or not, I've forgotten.
Spunkling or something?
Something
like that. Anyway, you do explore caves.
Yes.
How nice. And Transylvania, we'll get into that a little bit later. I want to wish you both good luck. You both cut the cards backstage?
Yes, we did.
Terrific. Just to let the folks at home know what's going on right now, we are about to do our tiebreaker. Each of my contestants has won a game, and Lacey's already set up the board for the tiebreaker. Don't forget about the prize cards. You've got a trip to Waikiki in there. Let's get going with our first question, audience poll question. We have 10 male models with us right now. Come up here, gentlemen. Look at this. 10 handsome male models, all possessing two factors that I despise, hair and height. But anyway, welcome to you, gentlemen. You all look great down there. And let's ask our first question of the tiebreaker, Jack. Dr. Joyce Brothers says men are just as vain as women. So before the show, we asked these 10 male models, do you agree? How many of these 10 models agree that men are just as vain as women?
Bill, if I had a head of hair and looks and a physique like those dadgum guys do.
Well, they're doing a lot with cosmetic surgery, Jack.
I would
say eight
out of those 10 agree with Dr. Joyce Brothers.
You're going with eight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Tundi, what do you think?
Yes, I think you're awfully good looking, Alexander.
He says eight.
But I think I'm going to go just a teeny tiny bit lower.
A little bit lower than eight.
A teeny tiny bit, yes.
I'm going higher. How's that? The actual number of these models who agree that men are just as vain is six. It is lower. Tundi is right. Tundi is right. Six agree. So that means that four do not agree. We're the four guys who are going the opposite way here. Who are the four guys who don't agree? Rand, give me your reason, sir. Robert.
I have short hair, and I'm into the shower, and I'm out of the shower, and my sister's the one who takes all the time, so leave it with the girls.
That's it. All right. Well, that's a good reason. Have a seat, fellas. Thank you very much. Cundy, here's your base card. Tell me what you want to do. You've got a nine.
I'd like to change that.
All right. We're going to change that nine. That nine now becomes a five.
I like to go higher. I like
goes
to go higher,
higher than a five. A jack.
All right, I like to go lower.
A jack. For the game, the match, $500 and that special ring. No! Queen, king, ace. Only three cards you could have gotten. It would have got you, and you found one of them. That means that Jack gets a free shot at the cards, but he must play from this card.
I'll take it.
He's got an ace.
I'll take it and go lower.
He's going lower. He's got a nine.
Bill, I'll go lower.
He's going lower again for that trip to Hawaii, the game, and the match. He's got it. hoping we stick around a little bit longer with you. You are wonderful. Good luck with your baby.
Thank you so much
for being here.
And it was a pleasure.
Oh, it's been a pleasure having you. Got some lovely parting gifts for you. Come on over here, Jack.
Thank you.
Bill, welcome back, champ. Good to see you. Gene, why don't you tell Jack about his trip to Hawaii?
Okay, Bill, Jack, you and the guests will travel to Honolulu, where you'll stay at the legendary Royal Hawaiian, the Pink Palace of the Pacific. Unsurpassed luxury and elegance right on Waikiki Beach. Spectacular views of the ocean and lovely tropical gardens furnished by the Royal Hawaiian Hotel. Congratulations, Jack.
All right. Thank you, Gene. This man's already got a trip to Tahiti. He's now got a trip to Hawaii. When we come back after this commercial message, he goes through the money cards. He can win $32,000 there. We'll be right back. Right now, to deal out the money cards, I can assure you that this gentleman knows how to play the money cards. But in addition to all the money he can win, we have added a joker to the deck. Anytime that turns up in the money cards, that means that Jack is going to have a shot at winning this brand new car. Gene.
A new Fiero GT Coupe, the car with a sleek new look and even more aggressive attitude. Fiero GT Coupe, only from Pontiac, worth over $15,000.
Thank you, Gene. Here we go. Now, Jack, you know now, Paul, come on up here. Come on up here a little bit closer. You know, of course, for winning our match, that we're going to guarantee you a chance at that car right now, because we're going to start you out with the joker, and Lacey's holding it over there for you. Let's get started right now. Let's give Jack $200. Jack plays it right. He's going to make a lot of loot. Jack, here's your base card. Tell me what you want to do, sir. You got a five. 200 on a five.
I'll bet 100 higher.
Going to keep the card?
I'll keep it.
Keep the card. Goes $100 higher than a five. A king. 300 on a king.
Let's bet all but 50 lower.
So you're going 250 lower.
250 lower.
250 lower than a king.
Mm-hmm.
It is.
It is. It is.
550 on an eight.
Let's change it one time. Change it. Number three. Number three.
Number three. That eight now becomes a six.
Okay.
550
okay.
on a six.
Let's bet about 150 higher.
150 higher than a six. He's got it. $700, Jack. Mm-hmm. We'll take you over here now. We're going to give you $400 more. You have $1,100. You're working on a 10.
Mm-hmm. 100 lower.
Keeps the card. He goes $100 lower than a 10. He's got it.
Hey, hey.
Got 1,200 on a 3.
Let's bet 1,000 higher.
1,000 higher than a 3. You got it. 2,200 on a 9.
Let's change number 2. Number 2.
Jack knows his cards right now. Let's get a good card up here. That 9 now becomes a 10.
Oh, well.
You've got 2,200 on a 10.
Let's bet 500 lower.
500 lower than a 10? A 4.
Hey.
Take a breath. You got $2,700. You're playing off of 4. You must wager at least $1,350 on this card up here.
2,000 higher.
Going to keep the card?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You're talking $2,000 higher than a 4. He's got it!
Hey! Grandfather.
4,700.
Ooh.
Ooh. Listen, you want to hear a number? Let me give you a number right now. $20,369 cash in prizes. A joker. A new car. We'll be right back. It gets more exciting. Come back and see it.
Lacey?
Just heard it. Yeah, Jack's ready to do it right now. This is when the real fun on the show starts. I love this. Nothing I like better than giving away a brand new car. Jack, you have one joker that Lacey's holding over here. I want to give that to you. Let me quickly tell you how you can win that brand new Pontiac GT. In front of you are 7 cards. Behind one of those cards is the word car. You find it with the joker, and I'm going to put your cash and your prizes in the glove compartment, and it's all yours. Go find it.
Bill, I told you last week I'm psychic. It's right there.
He's going for number 3.
Right there.
Going for number 3. The word car is behind number 3. This little guy's going to jump around. No!
No!
Ooh. Not bad. Not a bad trick. Where was it? Actually, it was over here. It was down here behind lucky number 7. There it was.
But
some of those people out there were ready. Watch your back, Jack. I want you to stand right here because you might be back here again. If you're a champion after this next match, you've got $20,000 in your pocket now. Who knows what's going to happen? Go stand over there and meet your challenge.
Hi, for it.
Come on out, Gene.
Okay.
Hello, Gene.
Hi.
Introduce yourself, please.
My name is Gene Roth, and I'm a professional musician. I play the French horn and piano.
play the French? Do you play with a symphony that we would know? Or
No, not that you would know.
Is it Al Symphony? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, Al. Yeah, that's it, Al.
Do you like freelance?
I'm a freelance musician.
How much studying does that take?
It takes a lot of practice, even now.
I bet it does. Mm-hmm. I bet it does. Well, good luck to you. You've cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I did.
Good luck to both my contestants. Just want to remind everybody about the prize cards. We've got a Caribbean cruise in there worth close to $4,000. And Lacey's already dealing out the cards right now for our first game. Jack always goes to our returning champion. Let's take a look at the first question, and here it is. This year, Playboy's Playmate of the Year happens to be a 33-year-old mother of two children. So we surveyed 100 people, and we asked them, do you think it's wrong for a mother to pose for Playboy? How many people said it is wrong?
If these beautiful ladies have it, why not flaunt it and take advantage of what they have? Even in Playboy?
I'll tell you, it'd really screw up show and tell in most schools, though. I'll tell you, here's Mom right here if you want to. Yeah, that's her. Yeah, that's...
But look at the money Mom gets. I would say 47 of them would say it's all right.
47? I've got to go again now. Do you think it is wrong for a mother to pose for Playboy? How many people said it is wrong?
I'll go lower. Let's say about 30 of them said it was wrong.
30 is wrong? Okay, Gene, higher or lower?
I'm gonna have to say that that's a little bit higher because I think that there's people that are going to say that it's wrong no matter who they are to pose in Playboy. But that's just what I think that people would say. So I think I'm going to go a little bit higher.
You're going higher than 30? I agree with Gene. I'm going higher. The actual number of people who said it is wrong for a mother to pose for Playboy is 35. It is higher, but not by a lot.
Good.
Gene, here's your base card. Tell me what you want to do, please. You've got a 7.
Change it.
I don't blame you. Let's get rid of that 7. We've got a 6.
Higher.
Higher than a 6, he says. A 6. So that means that Jack could be free shot at the cards right now. Got to play from this, Jack. A 5.
I'll go higher, Bill.
Goes higher than a 5. An 8.
I'll go higher, Bill.
He's going to continue on. He goes higher than an 8. A queen.
Lower, Bill.
Ooh, lower than a queen. A cruise.
The
Caribbean cruise I was talking about just came up on the board. Mary Susanna. Boy, Jack, you are going to be on the road
a very long time
if you win this thing. Let's replace that card right now and recap what we're talking about. You're going
that was lower, Bill.
Lower than a queen, he says. We've got a jack.
Lower, Bill.
Lower than a jack for game number one and one leg up on winning that cruise. There it is. You got your work cut out for you, young lady.
Puerto Rico.
You got your work cut out for you. I saw your face when that queen came up. I think you knew the handwriting was on the wall. Congratulations to Jack. He's got one game on his side of the board. First contestant to win two games, they win the match. And we're now ready to deal out the cards for game number two. There goes Lacey with them right now. And, Gene, I got to remind you, this is a must-win situation for you. You've got to win and tie it up in order of facing a tiebreaker and going on to the money cards, you hope. Let's get to it right now. Educated guess question for you, Gene. Got to think about this a little bit. Charles Lindbergh made the first solo nonstop transatlantic flight. Mm-hmm. How many hours did it take him to fly from New York to Paris?
I would say, as an educated guest, I would say 22 hours.
22 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Jack, higher or lower?
Bill, I remember the flight, but I don't remember the hours, but I'm going to say a little higher than that.
You're going a little bit higher than 22.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Crowd agrees. The actual number of hours it took Charles Lindbergh to fly from New York to Paris is 34 hours. It is higher. Jack was right. Champ goes back. Take a look at your card, Jack. A 9.
Change it, Bill.
He changes it. If you get the high-low question right, you can change it. That becomes a 2.
Higher, Bill.
Higher than a 2, says Jack. A 7.
Higher, Bill.
It's higher than a 7. He's in the middle. He gets a 3. Tough call on a 7. It's right in the middle. You never know where you're going to go with it. And, Gene, you get a free shot at the cards. Remember what Jack did when he got his free shot?
I remember all too well.
Here's your card. You've got an 8.
Have to play it.
You have to play it.
Lower.
Lower than an 8?
So,
cards are not doing too well for either of my contestants right now. Let's see what happens when we come back right after you hear a word from the folks in your neighborhood. Everybody, middle of our second game right now. Not a lot happening in the game. Just one card over for each of our contestants. Let's get right on to our next question, and this is the fun part. I always like these questions. This is our audience poll question. It involves 10 men who are professional models. Here they are right now. Come on, gentlemen. I have to say, it's quite interesting because Lacey and Susanna are paying a lot more attention now to the audience poll question than they used to. Anyway, here it goes. Jack, for you, sir. Do I have that? I took the wrong card, but that's the game show host to do. Okay. Before the show, we asked these 10 male models, when you were dating someone new, do you like it when she makes the first romantic move? How many of these 10 models said they do like it when a new date makes the first romantic move?
Bill, I think the guys like the conquest, not the freebie. So I don't think over 4 of them would like it.
The conquest, not the freebie, tonight on PBS. John Gielgud presents The Conquest, Not the Freebie. Be there. Okay, Jack, you're going with 4. What do you think, Jean?
Well, I think looking at these guys that a lot of girls would make the first move on them, and they get a little bit tired of that, although I'm sure they still enjoy it. But I would say that that number might be even a little bit lower. These guys would like the conquest, and fewer of them would like it.
All right, so you're going lower than 4.
Going lower than 4.
All right, the actual number of these models who like it when a new date makes the first romantic move is 9. It is not lower, it is higher. Where is your pride, gentlemen? No, I don't know. I can't blame you. But let's throw the odd man out. Who's the guy that says he wants to... Robert, why do I have a feeling we're going to learn a lot about you this week, Robert?
I don't know. Well, Bill, I'm a gambling man by nature. No, so I feel that I like to make the shots, make the first move.
Is your philosophy summed up with the conquest, not the freebie? Is that what we're going for?
I've just been brought up that way.
Okay, well, good for you, Robert. Thanks for sharing your thoughts with us. Gentlemen, have a seat over there, would you please? Here we are, Jack. Let's take a look at it.
Let's
He's going
go higher,
higher than
Bill.
A 2. He's got a 5.
Higher, Bill.
Higher than a 5. He's got an 8.
Freeze, Bill.
Freezes on the 8. Jack knows the cards aren't happening right about now. I think he's playing the edge. He knows his cards, this man. Next question, of course, it goes to Gene. Here it is, Gene. We surveyed 100 women business executives, and we asked them, if you could receive your present salary for working as a housewife, would you do it? How many women executives would become a housewife for their present salary?
Well, I think the type of woman that is a business executive is not necessarily in it for the money, although that is a very nice benefit. They're in it because it's a challenge. It's a chance to use their education. There's very many good things. It gives them self-confidence and something to do with their time. And so I would say that's a pretty low number that would trade being a housewife for their present job. So I would say that would be... 32.
32? Mm-hmm. Jack, higher or lower?
Bill, they didn't get to be an executive by changing diapers and swabbing floors, so I'm sure that they wouldn't.
You're still going...
Now, I'm going lower.
She's saying 32, you're saying lower.
I'm going lower.
You're going lower. Mm-hmm. Everybody agrees. I agree because they'd be underpaid, probably. That's the reason. The actual number of women executives who would become a housewife for their present salary is... 40. It is not lower, it is higher. It is higher. So, Gene, here's your 8.
Change the card.
Changes the 8. The 8 now becomes a 4.
Higher.
Little help. Little help.
Higher.
So it's higher than a 4. We've got a 10.
Lower.
Lower than a 10. We've got a 4.
Higher.
Higher than a 4. A queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. She's going to tie it up. Yes. Yeah. Way to go, Gene. Terrific. You had to do it. You did. You dyed it up right now. When we come back after this commercial message, we have a tiebreaker. Stick around. We're going to have some fun. Everybody, we have just about run out of time. We cannot continue on. That means that tomorrow we're going to pick it up with the tiebreaker, our champion, who has over $20,000 in his pockets, got his work cut out for him. He wants to stay champ. Lacey, Susanna, Bill, and Gene. We'll see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.